here are some obscure and hard to notice Android games of the previous month that are free and are not total shit. That means there is not too much shit in them. The first one on the list is Into the Badlands Champions. This is an action game based on popular martial arts TV series. Players control and upgrade a bunch of different characters related to the show while engaging in real-time fights with rival gangs. Into the Badlands Champions have unique and simple core mechanics. While in a fight, a player controls one single character from their roster. To move, you tap any empty space on the arena, and to attack, you tap at any enemy. Also, there are two stances, blue and yellow. Enemies use those to prepare their attacks. To avoid being hit and interrupt an enemy attack, a player should attack enemies in blue stance using a tap, as usual. And to attack enemies in a yellow stance, a player should swipe at them. Make a mistake and you will get punished by a strong counter-attack. That's it! Basic mechanics are very simple but well executed, which produces engaging and challenging gameplay. To make every character more unique, they are given special abilities which are available to use if the player manages to score a big hit combo. Abilities vary from character to character and mostly focus it on dealing serious unblockable damage while looking cool. Despite the game being mechanically simple and grindy free-to-play with card battler-styled progression, it favors a player's skill and creates no hard locks on progress, making it possible to beat new levels not because of upgrades but a player's decisions. The game even rewards flawless victories, so yeah, there is some skill element to it. Into the Badlands Champions has nice stylized graphics and juicy animations. Sometimes those can be funny if toyed around, just look at this. Suka, it was fun. The main narrative goal is rudimentary and revolves around capturing rival gangs' territories and defending them later. You capture a section of the city, get bonuses for doing so, and a new section unlocks. That is pretty much all the plot you'll have here. So, do not play if you expect a great story. This is about fights and not stories. The game has many characters to unlock and upgrade, and some other meta gameplay like PvP, alliances, and events to keep you busy. It even attempts to monetize players through grind and loot boxes. Good try, you free-to-play game. By the way, it's the best loot box animations I have ever seen. Check it out, blyat! Pew! Opening loot boxes by shooting them in the pitch black door. So, overall this is a unique free Android game with fresh mechanics. If you like the show, you should try Into the Badlands Champions. Number 2 is Ailment. This is a single-player top-down action shooter with a linear narrative. This game, made by a small team, mechanically resembles Soul Knight for Android and is heavily inspired by games like Dead Space in terms of story. In this short pixel art adventure, players control a guy named Jonathan, who wakes up on a spaceship full of zombies and has to find what happened there. As Jonathan, you'll have to do basic gaming stuff like killing zombies, finding new equipment and gathering allies for somewhat like 5 hours of gameplay. You can hardly say that 5 hours is a grind. This and the absence of forced ads make it a great Android game to play if you are into top-down shooters. The game is somewhat challenging and has a very retro feel to it. Sometimes you have to experiment with available weapons and choose different tactics to win the next fight. Good thing is that you have unlimited continues. Of course, for a game made by a small team, there are some troubles here and there, but they can be excused. Personally, I didn't like very linear and corridory level design and some weapons being shitty, but overall it was a fun experience. If you feel stuck, you can get a little health boost by watching the net, but it is perfectly fine without doing so and can be avoided. If you decide to play this, I would still recommend watching a few of these ads to support the dev. Monster Chef is the third game on my list. The best way to describe this unusual thing is farming game about managing a giant underground kitchen operated by monsters. Basically, the game goes like this. A player finds different monsters and forces them to produce specific ingredients. As an example, a flour bag monster can be exploited to extract some flour. Also, this guy is a spotty type, and room where this monster contain it is a gym. After getting ingredients, player should combine them to find new recipes with the help of this badass bot. Having recipes unlocked and ingredients ready, a player can order to prepare food, which can be sold for money later. Money, in turn, can be used to upgrade your kitchen. Finding new monsters in Monster Chef is a form of more active gameplay and represents a separate minigame similar to a scratch lottery. A player should drive a bike from tile to tile while having limited fuel. Monster is found when a player unlocks all tiles related to that monster. After that, a new monster is unlocked or an existing one can be upgraded. To be honest, this core game doesn't look like any fun to me and feels grindy from the start. But Monster Chef is on the list because of its incredible style, and it is a reason to enjoy the game at least for a while. Character design is a bomb, lore is pretty fleshed out, and there is some cool-ass chiptune. Blin, look at this bullshit, now look at that bullshit, and now look at this guy is busy producing food. Do you get it? Try the game if you do. Dead Rain 2 is a sequel to the famous Dead Rain in the game number 4 in the line. It is an action platformer with fresh visuals, story which is focused around zombies, and setting that probably inspired by Last of Us. To be true, I have no idea what is that previous Dead Rain game is like. Let's check. Oh, it's kinda the same game. But fear not, it's still a thing that we can enjoy. This is a fast-paced action platformer, where players can run away from zombies, shoot zombies, break things with hammers, kill other survivors, collect stars, use collected stars to upgrade skills, grow magical trees and do other stuff. The story and difficulty progression are represented in the form of different levels, which are consecutively unlocking as the player wins previous levels. One can revisit old levels to gather more stars to use for upgrades and farm more loot to upgrade gear. With gear and stars come RPG elements and possibilities to enhance and adapt for upcoming challenges. But here is some salt. Monetization attempts are coming this way too. Devbox, the developer behind Dead Rain 2, is trying to be serious and has its shop locked and loaded. Later in the game, players will probably find themselves grinding to get new upgrades and progress in the story. And that is not everyone's cup of tea. If such shit does not fear you and you have some time to spare, go ahead and play the game. If it does, you probably should try Dead Rain 2 anyways. And here is why. The game stands out not only by offering players decent gameplay. Dead Rain 2 also have a unique aesthetic to it. While having zombie apocalypse as the main theme, it looks and feels a lot like a fantasy game filled with magic. Just look at those forest beasts, tree-growing abilities, purple stuff and pits, magic gems, overall visuals, and you'll probably get what am I talking about. The next game is Deep.io. It is a multiplayer game about animals living in a water biome and occasionally hunting each other. Like in the most of the .io games, players compete with each other for dominance while becoming more and more powerful until they die and lose their progress. Leaving the game results in lost progress too. A player starts as a small sea animal of choice and immediately finds themselves in an aggressive environment where other players can attack them on the spot. To grow stronger, players have to collect experience by eating pellets that can be found everywhere, or by attacking and eating other players. The more powerful you become, the more will be your need to eat other players instead of pellets to make progress. When enough experience is collected, a player can evolve into a more powerful creature with different abilities. Deep.io offers many types of animals. This is a clownfish. It is faster while near other clownfish. It doesn't help. This is a crab. It can walk on land. It doesn't help too. This is a ray. It can turn invisible while sits on its head on the seabed, and it doesn't help. And this one is a bobbit worm. In theory, it can grab and pull animals to the bottom, and I can do shit to that lonely PewDiePie right here. Look at that. Now I am forced to retreat to my habitat since the pressure is low. Yes, creatures you can evolve into also have weak spots. As an example, this scum worm should live inside seabed and can't stay outside of it for too long. Overall, this is an interesting competitive game that represents something like an ecosystem you can take part in and probably be an apex predator while doing so. It is more explorative and meditative than your basic Dota game, since there are different creatures and locations in the game, and the pacing is a little bit slower. Play this game if you want to be a crab or a worm for a while. The last game for this video is Blackmoor 2. The second sequel on my list is a fantasy-themed beat-em-up 2D platformer with RPG elements. This is a challenging old-school styled game with a linear story, two difficulty levels, a variety of characters to play as, and additional modes that are there to make the game more diverse. Characters have unique mechanics, are upgradable, and can be equipped with items found in-game. Cool thing number one. Devs tried to make every single level as unique as possible in terms of gameplay. There are platforming levels, arena levels including riding an elevator, and levels with unique objectives like helping a group of humanoid pigs to repel a castle siege. Almost every level includes a new mechanic, and that is a great thing. Cool thing number two. Blackmoor 2 has two multiplayer mods. The first one is story co-op, and the second one is the PvP arena. Both of them are nice additions to the base game. Cool thing number 3. There is a level editor. That means you can play levels made by other players and make ones of your own. This is a very good thing if you will find Blackmoor 2 enjoyable in the first place, since you will be able to have a little bit more content, and sometimes stuff made by players may be even better than the original game. And here is a bad thing. To unlock all the content in the Blackmoor 2 for free, you'll have to grind a lot. Also, the game gives boosts for watching ads while difficulty may be too hard sometimes. We all know what that means. The developer wants you to watch those ads. In my opinion, this is acceptable, because Blackmoor 2 is still a free game and you can play it for free. Cool thing number 4. The game can be completed without paying or watching anything. Play Blackmoor 2 if you love old-school beat-em-ups and do not afraid of challenging gameplay and in-game ads. And thank you for staying with me for that long.